Many climate experts tell us that human-caused global warming is leading to a major loss of snow across the planet. The theory is simple. According to current computer climate models, since the Industrial Revolution, humans have been causing unusual global warming from our use of fossil fuels, such as coal, gas, and oil. On average, warmer temperatures should mean less snow. So the models tell us that snow cover should have been decreasing since the 19th century, and they say it will soon become a thing of the past. But is that really the case? Before we delve further, some of the scientific views within this video differ from those of the UN IPCC. To learn more about the latest IPCC reports, please visit their website at www.ipcc.ch. One of the most influential organizations worldwide when it comes to climate change is the United Nations Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, or IPCC, which is the United Nations body for assessing the science related to climate change. Created in 1988 by the World Meteorological Organization and the United Nations Environment Program, the objective of the IPCC is to provide governments at all levels with scientific information that they can use to develop climate policies. In Chapter 2 of the latest report titled Changing State of the Climate System, the IPCC describes the observed changes in snow cover since the mid-20th century. They say, the greatest declines in snow cover extent have occurred during boreal spring and summer, although the estimated magnitude is data set dependent. To support this claim, they refer to several studies, including a paper co-authored by scientists from CERES, the Center for Environmental Research and Earth Sciences. This 2019 paper was published in the peer-reviewed scientific journal Geosciences. Let's talk to some of the authors of that paper to find out if the IPCC was accurately describing the actual science or if they were just selecting the scientific information that governments at all levels could use to develop climate policies.
The IPCC was quoting our study in order to support their claim that the greatest declines in snow cover had occurred for spring and for summer. Technically, this was correct, but it would have been more correct if they'd explained the only declines had occurred for those two seasons. That's because autumn and winter have shown a general increase over the satellite record. Also, that satellite record, when it began in the 1960s, the scientists involved were actually concerned about global cooling. They had been observing from the ground measurements a general increase in snow cover since the 1940s. That's why they wanted a satellite record, to better study the phenomenon. So those declines for spring and summer since the 1960s actually followed several decades of climatic cooling. I guess, though, that was scientific information the IPCC felt was not useful for governments developing climate policies.
The IPCC heavily relies on computer models, or as they call them, global climate models. Global climate models are computer models that simulate the Earth's climate system. They incorporate various physical, chemical, and biological processes that influence the Earth's atmosphere, oceans, land surface, and ice cover. How do we know if these models are any good? The models make forecasts about future climate change called climate projections, but we can't test those forecasts until the future when it will be too late. Instead, to assess the reliability of these models, scientists often use an approach called hindcasting. Think of it as going back in time and predicting what should have happened in the past. Hindcasting involves comparing the output of the global climate models with known historical climate data. By comparing the model output with the actual historical data, scientists can evaluate how accurately the models simulate past climate conditions. The IPCC claims that their models do a good job of hindcasting climate change since the 19th century. The CERES team decided to see how good these model hindcasts did with snow cover. Connolly and his colleagues decided to look at the satellite data for snow cover in the Northern Hemisphere. This satellite data is the longest continuous satellite record of any environmental measurement, beginning in 1967. When the scientists did their analysis, they had 50 years of measurements to compare to the model hindcasts. The satellite data shows that there has indeed been a lot of climate change over the last 50 years, but the actual climate changes that occurred were nothing like what the computer models say should have occurred.
The IPCC climate model hindcasts for the Northern Hemisphere snow cover trend were dramatically wrong for all four seasons: autumn, winter, spring, and summer. Let's take a look at the comparison between the model hindcast of IPCC versus a satellite observation of the Northern Hemisphere snow cover from 1967 to 2016 or so. It is very clear from this graph that for the autumn and winter season, the satellite observations show actually increasing overall trend, whereas the model predicts strictly decreasing trend. Even when you move on to the spring and summer season comparison, for summer, you can clearly see that the model was spectacularly wrong too, because the observation shows that the summer snow cover is changing up and down in a dramatic fashion, and the numerical data simply do not agree with what the climate model hindcast is saying.
Connolly et al. Found that there was no steady decline in snowfall as the computer model said there would be, but rather a fluctuation of cooling and warming. If the IPCC's models are unable to accurately explain what has happened in the last 50 years, including the fact that the observed trends did not match the predictions, this raises questions about the reliability of their future projections. It suggests that the models may not fully capture the complexity and variability of the Earth's climate system, and that the assumptions made in the models may not be accurate. But if our best computer model predictions are wrong, how should we prepare for the climate changes in the future?
The problem with computer model predictions is that they're really only as good as the assumptions that are used to build the models. The IPCC's computer models got it wrong for snow cover. This means that there is something wrong with their assumptions. It doesn't make sense to be making policies based on computer model predictions which we know are wrong. Instead, governments should be making their policies based on the actual records. The records for snow cover show that snow cover can increase as often as it decreases.
At the moment, most climate policies are based on trying to prepare for future climate change using the computer models. But as we saw, those models that predict snow disappearing due to global warming have been wrong for all four seasons. Instead of relying on these flawed computer models that only predict snow cover decreasing, policymakers should be preparing for the reality shown by the satellite data. Snow cover can increase or decrease from year to year. If we only expect that snow cover will decrease, we will be badly prepared when the next big freeze comes. For more information about this paper and other work by the Ceres Group, please visit www.ceres-science.com. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to like, subscribe, and turn on notifications for upcoming content. Thanks for watching.